And it's a very warm welcome back to the Alliance Park here in North London for the second semi-final of the NatWest Schools Cups weekend here at the Alliance Park. This is the second Vase semi-final between Oakham School and Bishop Wordsworth School. Davis, back in scrum half. This is Hugh Davis. This is Tyrese Johnson-Fisher, who's got good legs, as you can see. As you can see, he's quick. He's very quick. He's too quick for everybody. Wow, what a start for Oakham. That man's got wheels.
Well, what an unbelievable start, and look at that celebration. Dream start for Oakham, the first time they've had hands on the ball.
Boot down from Seb Davis, up in the air, who wants it? It's gone into Tyrese Johnson-Fisher's hands, the try scorer. And the penalty has been conceded. And Bishop Wordsworth in a dangerous area here, Dave. Have a penalty, what are their options?
Yeah, all offside there from Oakham, from the kick. It wasn't the best of strikes. You can see there that he's just snatched at the kick a little bit. It was a good take in the air from Johnson-Fisher, but he was offside, well spotted by the referee.
So Norris, this to reduce the deficit to 4 points.
Good strike.
Over it goes.
Well, Oakham responding to that last-ditch defence.
It is, in fact, an intercepted line-out by number four, George Figgis. And he has put Oakham 12 points to 3 clear.
Wordsworth to defend there, because as soon as the ball's caught, you've got the players in blue committed to the catch. And it's just a few yards to the line there for the second rower to open his account. Oh,
and
space
Oakham
here.
Off again. Tyrese Johnson-Fisher to his right-hand side. Is he going to use him? He is going to use him. And he's away is the big lad. Tyrese Johnson-Fisher, try again.
Well, that's all about the work from the fullback there, Ben Bolton-Smith. It's basic stuff. It's a two-on-one.
17-3. This one, 19-3. Over it goes. Seb Davis, 19 points to 3. Pereira. Tom Boxer. Boxer with a little bit of room. Good hands off from Boxer and gets up to the 22. McFarland. Loose pass. And under pressure here are Bishop Wordsworth, but they keep hold of it with Paddy Case. Paddy Case now. Good offload it was indeed. And a chance here for Bishop Wordsworth to respond. Harry Norris, this to
careful.
Just the arrears to 9.
They're not ours, no.
Oh, right in the heart, isn't it, as well? That is just a superb kick. Absolutely superb. Oh. So another chance here for Oakham to relieve the pressure that's been put on him in the last 5 or 6 minutes by Bishop Wordsworth. Davis, a little chip forward this time, but it's down the throat of number 11, Daniel Mitchell. Mitchell, what can he do with the counter-attack? Trying to burrow that ball out, and they find it indeed. Norris. Norris with a little bit of space, and he's going through the gears as well. Just good last-ditch tackle there by Ben Bolton-Smith. But Bishop Wordsworth getting through the gears, and they may get down here. Number 8, has he got there? He has indeed. Tom Boxer, I think it is, with the try.
By contrast, Paddy Case, a really intelligent ball carrier.
McFarland, second try scorer. Harry Norris kicks it downfield. It doesn't find touch, but it's an awkward bouncing ball. Bolton Smith, the fullback. Ball in his hand, he's holding it like a loaf of bread. Hugh Davis. Bolton Smith again.
There's numbers here.
Numbers on the left-hand side. And here's the big man, Johnson-Fisher, with the running.
Oh.
Oh, just demolishes him. Demolishes him. He pushed him over like a cardboard cutout to score that try.
What a way to bring up your hat-trick.
Yeah. 26 points to 15 at half-time. And what's our first half of rugby we've seen here, Dave? Fairly taken by Joe Tolley. Tackled by his opposite number, Ben Bolton-Smith. Tom Boxer. He's had a good game for Bishop Wordsworth. Trying to snatch the ball away, but they win the penalty. No options here, Dave. 11 points down. They're going to go with the tap and go. They fancy it. Harry Norris.
Again, there's numbers if they can execute.
James Kennedy. Out wide. This is Daniel Mitchell over in the corner. Game back on again.
Clearance kick option has usually been Ben Bolton-Smith, and he's lining up outside Johnson Fisher at the moment, so I wonder whether or not they're going to try and run this, but that's a great scrum there.
Van Puvelay, Seb Davis, Hugh Davis, Therese Johnson Fisher, going romping through the gears, and he's off and running again. He's going up the wing, flying, absolutely flying. Ron Mantabidi, he's still going strong. One try line to the other, wow. Absolutely superb, wow.
Well, we called it, didn't we? The way they were lining up, it looked as though they were going to run it. Johnson Fisher. This lad is a talent. That's his fourth try.
Seb Davis adds the extras. 13 points now, the difference.
Impose a little bit of calm on organisation.
Van Puvelay with the put in at the scrum. Picked up by Lucas Lovatt. Ben Bolton-Smith, Hugh Davis. Van Puvelay. Johnson Fisher. Excellent, excellent pass from Johnson Fisher. This is Ben O'Boyle. And that could be Oakham heading to Twickenham. Great kick.
Yeah, that's a good kick.
Tom Boxer. He's had a good game, Boxer, and deserves his try. Very much so.
Yeah, credit to Tom Boxer. He's had a fantastic game from number eight.
Harry Norris to add the extras. Good kick from Norris. I'm going to change David Clean out line out as well.
Well, you say clean.
Bishops have it. It's been lost and it's in the hands of Hugh Davis. And Davis is going to put the icing on the proverbial Sunday, is he? He will do.
Yeah, Hugh Davis. Well, we said that Tom Boxer's performance deserved a try, but I think Hugh Davis's does too.
Over it goes. Seb Davis adds the extras, and that's the icing on the cake. 47 points to 27. Oakham have beaten Bishop Wordsworth. Bishop Wordsworth can leave the field with their head held high. They really did, gave Oakham School a really great game of rugby here. 7 tries to 4 in the end. Great stuff and a great advert as well.
Jeremy, well, what a game of rugby that was. Perhaps one of the best we've seen this week. Ken, tell me, how do you feel?
Yeah, we're absolutely elated. It was just a massive game and all credit to Bishop Wordsworth. They were fantastic. Great set of kids, great set of coaches, and they just never gave up. And they really pushed us right to the end. And I thought at one point I thought we could we'd lose it, but the boys just dug deep and we pulled away at the end. It was fantastic.
Well, it was a topsy-turvy game, wasn't it? You pulled away, then they got back into it, then you pulled away again. Fantastic team performance, but one name that will live on for quite a long time, I think, after this game, was that of Therese Johnson-Fisher, your captain. An outstanding performance, 4 tries here.
Yeah, he's an absolutely wonderful athlete. He's, as you say, he's a junior national sprinter, national 100-metre champion. But in all fairness, you know, he does a lot of the, you know, he scores the tries, but a lot of the boys do all the work on the inside. We get the ball to him early, they've got to execute the pass, give him the space, and he just finishes it off. And it was lovely to see him put Ben O'Boyle in for a try at the end and didn't take it on his own. He fed the try, so he showed that he gives passes as well as scores tries.
Well, a true team player, and it really was a team performance, but not just team, was it? Because you've got some fantastic support here. You can hopefully bank on that at Twickenham in 2 weeks.
Absolutely. We've got a great heritage at Oakham for rugby, and I think the 2011, the boys under-18s got into Twickenham for the final, and a huge crowd went down, so we're hoping to see the same again. So hopefully the headmaster will sign it off and we can get a few boys and girls down to Twickenham on the whenever the date is. Fantastic.
Well, it's Wednesday the 25th of March. I'm sure a lot of people will want the day off on that day to come and see you. And I was talking to the coach of Bishop's Wordsworth, and they were saying, and I'm sure you feel the same, that being able to take your team after a long season to Twickenham, it means everything, doesn't it?
It does. It's wonderful for us. Our first game, we lost by about 55 points, I think it was, and the boys have come on a huge journey. And it just comes down to just hard work and commitment as a team and sticking together. And, you know, we're a hockey term this term, but we've just stuck together, and the school have been really, really, really supportive. So we're looking forward to going to Twickenham now.
Well, best of luck to you. It's going to be a great day and a fantastic occasion. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. See you again.